over 2 million Model A Fords made, and Model A Fords were made between 1928 and 1931. And right now there are approximately 200,000 in the country. They came in various types. This is a four-door because it has four doors. There was a two-door that had two doors and roadsters, cabriolets, Victorias that had a huge trunk, and then various kinds of trucks, and those were the basic models. Their prices range between about $375 to about $600-$700 during that era.
My dad went to Detroit to buy a car for my grandfather in 1940, and he was actually looking for a Model A, and he ended up buying this one, which is a 1931, a Model A that was in the Ford Museum for 9 years, because it's 20 millionth, and it was the most photographed, publicized car in the world at the time. It made a tour of the country, and then it went into the museum. But Ford decided they didn't need it anymore, so they sold it, and my dad bought it. Sold it to my grandfather in Pelkey, who's a farmer, and with the agreement that he would get it back. And so when my grandfather bought a new car in 1952, my dad got it back. And then I got it from, my dad passed away in 1958, and he wanted me to have the car back, so I got it back. But my dad always said, this is a valuable car. You know it was a 20-dollar. Don't sell it, don't wreck it, keep it. So I've done that.
In one of his other cars, which is a 1919 single door Model T.
Yeah, a bunch of these guys are
and
staying at the
what was fascinating
behind,
is that
okay, yeah.
The car was originally purchased new by my great grandfather.
Today of one
and on the dashboard, stapled to it, is the original driver's license of my great grandfather. So I keep urging Joe and letting him know that someday that car's got to make it back to the family. I live on the same property that my grandfather did. So it's the same address. He's got copies of the original title of my great grandfather. So I keep working on it. And the last offer was, I'll pay you whatever you want for the car, and you can have it as long as you want. Just when you're done with it, it needs to come home. So we're still working on it. We hope to get it back.
So these are different cars than the cars that we see outside.
This is a fine point car, so that means that it has to be, you're rated on everything being original and correctly done as it would appear when it came out of the factory. So yeah. So even the color, everything has to be, try to get everything to just the way it should be, the sheen, everything has to be the way it wants.
And so it took you and your husband 12 years to?
It took him 12 years. I'm not going to take credit.
and how long have you two been married?
Actually, it's 31 years. It's 31 okay. years. Yeah.
And you're still married after that?
Still married after all that.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So how do you go about getting a convention like this to have it in Montana? What does it take?
Well, I'll tell you, I was at my friend's gas station, and I was already a MAFCA member, Model A Ford Club of American member. And I had the magazine open, and I looked in there, and I was like, hey, you're looking for a chapter to host a national convention. That was about 5 years ago. So I said, what do you think? I don't know if we can do that. Well, time went by, and we put it in there, put in a bid, and they were kind of reluctant because we're such a small chapter, but even though we're a small chapter, I think the big thing, big leverage boost was it was Henry Ford Country in the background.
Henry's
vacation land.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I think that's the biggest reason we got the bid.